Can we give God some praise for what he's doing up in the house?
Hallelujah.
Amen, amen, amen. Father God, Lord, we just thank you. We thank you, Lord, for those that you've brought here to be just water baptized in obedience to you as an outward testimony of the work that you've done inside of them. Lord, we thank you for their decision to follow you in obedience and water baptism. And we just give you praise, Father God, for all you're doing. Amen?
Amen.
Oh, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. So I know we got several of them that's just ready to jump in right now. I've had a few of them say they might stand up here on the stage and jump up right there. No? Oh, Dan says he can do it from the balcony. That might be worth seeing. It just might be worth seeing. All right. Huh?
Yeah, right over here, brother. Share something about you, Brooklyn. Do you have a testimony you want to share?
Yeah. Don't drop it in the water.
No testimony? Really? So Dan started coming here about a week, Memorial Day last year, maybe a little before. The week after Memorial Day, he got to church. He was the first one. He came running in, pretty much, almost, right? I got a question for you, Cindy. And he asked me this question. I'm not going to share what all they were, but it's personal. And the Lord was at work, wasn't he, today? And so we just asked him, Dan, do you want to follow Jesus? Do you want to become a believer? And you made a decision that day, didn't you? This man has been growing like, I tell you what, the Lord lit a fire in him for his word, like you all would believe. He's in his word every day.
Amen.
I mean, he sends me questions. What's this? What's that? God's been at work. And we just give God praise for you. We thank you, Lord, for bringing Dan to us as a brother in Christ.
Yep.
It's pretty cool.
Say, clear down.
All right, now wait a minute. One hand hold your nose. Dan, not yet. Have you decided to follow Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior?
Yes.
Amen. We baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. She come out over a year ago. She started coming to church here. She showed up. She was just hungry for the Lord.
She really was, because my stomach was like,
she was. She was almost 8 months pregnant then. And not quite. You might have been 7 months pregnant then. What? Well, you went into Godly Hope House weeks after. Yeah. Anyway, I'm going to try not to cry. She didn't know that God had been working on my heart. Watch God. And wasn't ready. We were working on it behind the scenes, and she's coming to church, and when we have found out she's homeless and living in her car while she's big pregnant. And so said, well, Vicki, the house ain't ready yet. If we can get a bed today, you can move in. And she moved in the next day, wasn't it? 3 days afterwards, she went into emergency preeclampsia labor. And that little man was our first agape hope house baby as a result. And y'all might be bothered by his noise and stuff. We ain't bothered at all. I tell you what, the Lord is raising him up to be a mighty hope. And Jesus saved him. And he just comes up here and watch. I believe God's going to raise him up to be a powerful man of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We just declare that in Jesus' name. And we're proud of you.
Amen.
We know it's been hard, but we're so proud of you. And we are so thankful for your obedience to the Lord.
I wasn't trying to rush. Really? It was warm this morning.
It's still
warm. If you decide to follow Jesus,
yes, I am.
Commit your life to Him as your personal Lord and Savior.
Yes, I am. Oh, okay.
Okay. I can hold your elbow with you. We baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Lauren's another one. She struggles, right? She has struggled, and God is still at work. He's still calling her, drawing her, transforming her into the beautiful masterpiece that He's created her to be. And we thank God for you. Thank you for doing it in you. We thank Him. And even though it's hard at times, you know, even though you want to, sometimes you just keep on pressing. And so we pray that the Lord just strengthen you. And that He opened the windows of heaven today as you follow Him in obedience.
Yes.
He's compelled you to be water baptized today. We love you. Have you decided to follow Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior? All right. As a disciple. We baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Woo! Wow, literally, I prayed with Peggy, his wife. She prayed him into existence, I
Amen.
Think. She was like, Lord, I want a man with a beard, and he's got to look like this, and he's got to be like that. I know, you cleaned up. You look younger, man. Anyhow, there he came. And it's been a joy to know him, get to know him more. I've known him for, I don't know, quite a few years.
Yeah.
I united him and his wife in marriage, had the privilege and honor of doing that. And I am just thankful that he's decided to follow the Lord and believe in baptism today.
You're fine.
Oh, what an honor. Travis, have you decided to follow Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior?
Yes, I have.
All right. Hey, did you want to share anything?
I'm just glad that I'm doing this
It's been a while, and
you all hear him?
I have rededicated my life to the Lord, and now I'm one of his followers.
Amen. Amen. We love you, brother. Baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Woo! Thank you. All right, who we got now?
Bill,
come on down. Julie, can you come down here with him for a minute?
You might want to dry out first.
Yeah, you're all wet.
I don't want you to
hand me one. Kayley, hand me a towel, would you? You think I might get shot?
There's a possibility. How about I'll do this? Sure?
Yeah.
All right.
I sit on them all the time. So these two, I met them at Pittsville Assembly, amen, and they were in Connect Group, and we just loved on one another. We did all kinds of stuff together, and then they up and deserted us, moved out to the state of Washington, imagine that, and from time to time, they fell away from the Lord, too. But then we was talking on the phone, and we kept talking, and one day she come back for a visit. When she landed the plane, the Lord started talking to her that she's supposed to come help us with this church. So they moved back. Long story short, they moved back from the state of Washington to grow in the Lord, rededicate himself to the Lord, and help with this church. And just, I don't know, even I think before we were talking about them baptisms, Julie comes to me one day and she said, you know, I need to rededicate myself. And I was like, well, praise the Lord. And then it wasn't too long after that, Bill grabbed me and pulled me off to the side in the other room. And I won't share everything he said, but the Lord was working hard on him too. Amen. And I'm proud of you. I'm proud to have you as a brother, sister in Christ. I'm thankful for your service. Serve the Lord alongside of you. And have you both decided to follow the Lord as your personal Lord and Savior?
Absolutely.
Amen. And he's going first? Do you want to go get a picture? You can. Or you can stay right here and be in the picture.
I gotta get my.
Do you want to help me do this?
Oh my gosh, I would love to do that.
Come on.
That might not be a good idea.
So you're gonna put your hand here. Don't keep your hand on his back. Don't hold him down.
What?
Don't hold him down.
I had an agreement. I was making sure he was
holding him. You're holding him. And then grab him. Sure. Keep it close to your chest. Bill, we baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Dry your face off and stay in there if you want. Julie, glasses off.
Yeah.
Julie,
my sister, my friend. I love you.
I love you.
And it's an honor and privilege to baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
My desire to be rebaptized is because God is doing some amazing things in my life through this church, through the community, and it's going in a different direction than I ever thought it would be. I never thought I'd be going into ministry, and I'm just so blessed. And the Lord started speaking to me and said it's a new chapter. It's a completely different area, so that's what I need to do, and I'm thankful. I love Jesus. I'm so thankful for what he did.
Amen. She can be a chatterbox on it's just us, right? Have you decided to follow Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior? You think you know what it means? All right. You love the Lord? Amen. I want you to hold your nose and then take this hand and hold on to your elbow and just keep it close to your chest, okay? And Danny's got that sign. We baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. All right.